गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द फोर्थ क्लास फोर्थ चैप्टर सेल. सो फर्स्ट क्लास इट वॉज सेल इंट्रोडक्शन, सेकेंड क्लास प्लांट सेल, थर्ड क्लास एनिमल सेल एंड द फोर्थ क्लास दैट इज प्रोटोप्लाज्म. देन इम्पोर्टेंट फंक्शंस ऑफ सेल एंड हाउ मच सेल इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट इन आवर बॉडी, दैट मच इज इन दिस क्लास. सो दिस इज द फोर्थ क्लास. So today's topic is that protoplasm. So before explaining about protoplasm, that you should know what the cytoplasm and nucleoplasm. Cytoplasm already that you have studied, nucleoplasm also you have studied. Then cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is the jelly-like matrix present outside the nucleus. So jelly like matrix present outside the nucleus of a cell, that is cytoplasm. And nucleus, that you know, controlling part of the cell present inside the cell, if it is a plant cell or an animal cell, nucleus is present, that is cytoplasm. Nucleoplasm matrix present inside the nucleus. So the matrix present inside the nucleus, that is nucleoplasm. So cytoplasm present inside the class or inside the cell outside the nucleus, nucleoplasm matrix present inside the nucleus. Now what is protoplasm? The cytoplasm and nucleoplasm and nucleus togetherly called a protoplasm. So cytoplasm and nucleus togetherly called a protoplasm. Now what is cytoplasm, what is nucleoplasm, what is protoplasm? This is a cell, animal cell, and in this animal cell, this is the outer boundary, that it is the plasma membrane. Inside the plasma membrane, the viscous fluid that which it is present, that is the cytoplasm. And here it is a nucleus. Here the cell organelles are scattered. So inside the plasma membrane, outside the nucleus, the jelly-like fluid which is present, that is the cytoplasm. That is the cytoplasm. Now inside, next one is the nucleoplasm. Inside the nucleus, nucleolus is there, chromatin fibers are there, and the matrix which is present, that is the nucleoplasm. Nucleoplasm. So nucleoplasm is present inside the nucleus, that is nucleoplasm. Now this cytoplasm and nucleus togetherly called protoplasm. So the next part of this chapter is that every activity of living organism is the outcome of cellular activity. Means each and every organism's body performing different activities. All these activities, that is the outcome of a cellular activity. That is why in the beginning of this chapter that you have studied, you have learned, cell is the structural and functional unit of life. In unicellular organisms, all the activities that it is performed by a single cell. So that is why at the end of this chapter here that you are going to learn, every activity of a living organism is the outcome of a cellular activity. Now which are that cellular activities or that is taking place and what is the result of that cellular activity? The first process that which is taking place in our body, that is growth. So the cellular activities, that is the growth, that cellular activity that which result in growth. So here in this picture, that which shows growth of bean seed. All organisms grow due to growth in size and increase in the number of cells. Increase in number of cells means that we are sowing the seed in that soil, and after that the seed which germinate, after germination the seed growing it into a seedling, the seedling changing it into a tree. This is the process that it is called growth. So this growth means it is the cellular activity. Cellular activity, that is a cell division. Due to cell division, growth and development takes place. That is in case of plants and also in animals. The second point is that repair. Repair, here that you can see. Repair means injured cells replaced with the help of a new cell. So old cell or injured cells replaced with the help of new cells. Liver cells. Liver cells, they are having the power of regeneration. Or blood cells, they are having definite lifespan. After a definite period of lifespan, they are replaced. For that process of regeneration, cell and cellular activities are necessary. That is why the second point that we learned, it is the repair. Another cellular activity that is taking place in our body, that is movement. Movement of the body is due to contractibility of the cells of the cellular parts. Animals walk, run, jump, swim or fly with the help of muscles. Here in this picture that we can see various type of movement that is responsible. This activity is with the help of cell and cellular functions. Now, even the flow of blood in blood vessel and the passage of food in the gut are the result of muscle cell contraction. In case of birds, feathers which help the bird to fly are also the product of cells. The drooping of leaves in case of, especially in case of touch me not plant, and that is called Mimosa pudica or touch me not plant. When we touch, it is the sensitive plant that it fold its leaves. That is also a type of cellular activity. In plants, the bending movement of roots towards the water or gravity, that means phototropism, geotropism, such type of activities of plants. Shoot of the plant is growing towards light. That is a cellular activity. Meristematic tissues, that which is helps in growth of the plant, root tip and shoot tip which is growing, and the growth of the root towards the gravity, that is geotropism, and growth of the shoot towards the sun. Sunlight, that is phototropism. So these are all cellular activities. That is why we can consider that it is under the cellular activity, that it is movement. So this is the picture that which shows various blood cells. And this blood cells are of three different types. They are, so blood cell, that it is, this is the RBCs or red blood cells. This red blood cells are responsible for respiratory gas transportation. That means this red blood cells are red in color because of hemoglobin present, and hemoglobin is having the capacity to carry oxygen as in the form of oxyhemoglobin and carry to each and every part of our body. So that is a cellular activity, transport of oxygen as in the form of oxyhemoglobin. These are the WBCs, different types of WBCs are this. And this WBCs, they are giving protection to our body from various disease causing germs. That is why increasing our immunity, and also that it is giving defensive mechanism, defensive power. So WBCs, they are the cells, but cellular activity protecting our body from disease causing germs. And this is the third type of blood cell, that is the blood platelets. Blood platelets, that which is helps in clotting of blood. Any injury happened in our body, free flow of blood is get stopped with the help of blood clotting mechanism. For blood clotting mechanism, blood platelets are responsible. So these are the cells, but the cellular activity, that which it is, helps in the proper functioning of our body. Another cellular activity is that photosynthesis. So green plants, they can prepare their own food with the help of various raw materials. Raw materials are sunlight, then carbon dioxide, water and chlorophyll, chloroplast, that is present here in this green leaf. The cell in plant cell, plastids are present. Already that you have studied, plastids are three different types: chloroplast, chromoplast, leucoplast. Chloroplast function is that photosynthesis. So chloroplast, that is chloroplast and its function, it is a cellular activity. Through the process of photosynthesis, plants, they are producing oxygen. Oxygen, that is very important gas which is required for plant animals for respiration. And the plants, they are preparing food materials as in the form of glucose. So it is a cellular activity. Another cellular activity that which it is given in this picture, that is circulation of blood. Circulation of blood and movement of other body fluid. Lymph is moving inside our body, other movement of body fluid in the body are through forces set up by the contraction of muscle cells of the heart or other parts. So because of this, the force that which is created by the contraction of the muscles of the heart, because of that, the body fluid circulating inside our body, that is also another cellular activity. In this way, every activity of a living organism is the outcome of cellular activity. So they are growth of plants and animals' body, repair, movement, feeding and nutrition, circulation of blood, transport of respiratory gases, body protection, sensation, sensory organs are functioning, all the sense organs working, thermoregulation. Thermoregulation means temperature maintenance. Thermoregulation by cellular activity, and we cool it when it's hot by sweating from gland cells in the skin. Sweat glands are present in the skin. Sebaceous glands are there. It is producing sebum secretion. So sweat glands, that which is producing the sweat which make the body cool. As that is why it is coming under this thermoregulation. Reproduction, single cell organism is dividing it into many. So that is also in case of amoeba, already that you have studied. Single organism's body is dividing it into two daughter cells. That is also cellular activity, reproduction. Absorption of water in plants. Absorption of water in plants with the help of unicellular structure, that is root hair. Class 8th, first chapter that you are studied this one, absorption of water in plants. Photosynthesis, already right now that I was explained. Pollination in flowers. Pollination in flowers means the flowers are beautifully colored. The coloration or beautiful color of the flower because of coloring pigment which is present in that cells. And that coloring pigment that is present inside the cell giving flowers, that is also a type of cellular activity. Now this way, every activity of a living organism is the outcome of cellular activity. So that is why there is not a single activity in the body of an organism which is not carried out by the cells, but cells, of course, are specialized for particular functions. This much is this chapter, that which explained about a cell, cell structure, cell functions, cell inclusions, then difference between prokaryotic cell, eukaryotic cell, plant cell, animal cell, protoplasm and cytoplasm, protoplasm, cytoplasm and nucleoplasm, difference between them. Then last point, every activity of a living organism is the outcome of cellular activity. This much is this chapter. Now that we will conclude this chapter with question answers. Thank you.